Welcome everybody to a new video. Today's video is I'm actually going to talk about the recent news headlines about the disease, Ebola virus disease, and this disease is popping up in the news recently about the outbreak in Africa that's happening currently at the moment. And I know I don't really do stuff like this, these videos, but I just wanted to give my input on it and hopefully give an understanding to you guys on what this is about. I know I'm not the smartest guy, and I have got some of my information from resources. I will put a link down in below, and let's just get into the video. So the Ebola disease is a disease, it's a man-made disease, and it's formerly known as the Ebola hemorrhagic fever. I do not know how to pronounce it. And it's like an illness in the body which can make you do some horrendous stuff. And I'm just going to play some Minecraft in the background, and if you mind, stop my country. So I'm not going to really care about this game really, but, and I'm sorry this does not refer to any disease and all that. I just wasn't bothered installing Left 4 Dead or something like that. So yeah, it's a disease made through humans. I'm highly sure it's not compatible through animals, even though we are animals, but yeah, you do get me. It's actually happening in Africa a lot, as we speak of now, and there's been lots of news reports in Australia and those countries and all that, and I don't know what I'm still going into, but I'm gonna chuck right now. You're going to see what the Ebola virus looks like under a microscope. So enjoy that. It's like a little langy thing, I guess. I don't really know how to pronounce it and all that. But the problem is Ebola has no cure, and has no cure or antihistamines, or it can be treated, but if you have Ebola, you will have Ebola for the rest of your life, or to the rest until you die. Because if you have Ebola, you will start to have seizures, and you will have to have explosive, basically diarrhea, meaning you will shit diarrhea until you stop shitting for the rest of your life. Okay, you can die from explosive diarrhea because you're gonna just shit and shit and shit. So and you will start to get seizures, you'll get headaches, you will get headaches, you will feel sick, you will have hay fever, but you will start getting colds and all that, and then you start bleeding out of your eyeballs. And who wants to bleed out of their eyeballs these days? So Ebola is actually transferred through each other by human liquids and human fluids, like blood, mucus, spit, semen, and something else. But I'll put all the four up there that I know. I know four. I just can't recall them on the top of my head. So, it has no vaccine to it. If you have Ebola, you have Ebola for basically forever, and that kind of stuff. And I know it's gonna seem scary at first. I know it's gonna seem scary at first, but like, if you're scared, I understand you're scared. Like, I would not blame you. I was scared until I actually did research on it, and when I did research, I found out, I'm like, oh, okay. So I'm just not going to be doing this stuff for a while, and I'm never going to fly to Africa. Okay, cut. Then now it's people are getting worried because it has spread to America. I think there's like one person actually has been I don't think quarantined yet, but has been known to have Ebola in the American United States, and I don't know where in the United States, but someone does have it. And I believe there's only been one person to ever survive Ebola, and that was an 11-year-old boy, and all that. But the third topic I'd like to talk about it is all the fuss that's going around, and all the stuff you're seeing on your social networks. And I'm seeing a lot on my social networks, such as Facebook and YouTube and all that, and Vine. And I understand that you're scared and you are asking questions. But there is no need to write a Facebook status to say, what is Ebola? Seriously, you have the resources at hand, but you choose to write a status on a resource, Facebook, that is not completely true half the time, and it is Facebook, and you're gonna hit me. It is Facebook, or I'm gonna hit you. It is Facebook, and not everything you believe on Facebook is true. And I understand that everyone is scared. I've said this about a million times, but I was scared, and now I'm not really. I know I'm not the best explainer to the Ebola virus, but I'm doing the best I can. I'm not the best with dealing with it, and I'm not gonna be. And all that. So if you are getting signs of headaches and all that, I don't know what to do, just go to your local doctor and all that and just get that checked out, basically, because you might have the Ebola virus. And I'm joking, and I shouldn't be joking about the time curses like this. And I'm just referring back to the stuff that's been said over the broadcast. And now, there has been cases of a woman from Africa who's been working in a Ebola hospital in Africa, and has recently came back home to Australia and has symptoms and signs of actually having the Ebola virus. And I just want to say, Australia, you're a bloody idiot for letting that person in. Something, and they've mentioned about something about, or no Ebola, like, people are going to enter Australia. But then this one sniffed past your eye, and she got in. So what are you gonna do about that, mate? But I'm highly sure she's quarantined now, and all of that. So I just want to say, guys, it's just, I'll put a link down to, like, a all the links I use to find this, and that kind of stuff. But I just want to say, guys, if you're scared, don't be, unless you live in the Gold Coast in Australia or America, where the disease is taking part, or even in Africa, because I'd actually be quite scared if you live in Africa. I'm not trying to haunt you or anything, but you do get what I mean. But I just want to say, guys, just stay safe, because we're people and we need to restore humanity. And I'm not ending the video here. So now to the last outbreak of Ebola that happened a couple not centuries ago, but a couple, like, tens of years. There was a outbreak of it, and 300 people died, and that's actually not that much. But I'll put a chart up now saying what are the death rate is now, and how fast it's spreading. It is spreading really fast, and I don't know what the people have been doing, but it's spreading really fast, like really, 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 really fast. It's faster than, and all that. I know I'm not the best explainer, because I can't really explain things while talking about the game. I do apologize for that, but I was actually going to record a game then. So yeah, I'm just. There's also, I've got to say this earlier, there's also ways to, there's body fluids and two or three types of animals, which is fruit bats, most likely in Africa and all that, and especially the fruit, just bat droppings. If you work in the bat dropping business, I would actually be careful about that. And gorillas. Fruit bats and gorillas can actually spread Ebola, so it's just not body fluids. But I don't think any of my viewers actually hang out with gorillas, unless you're cool with that, and yeah, that stuff, man. But yeah, I'll be careful about that. And fruit bats. I actually do have a lot of fruit bats in our house, but I don't go touching them because, like, I'm not an idiot, and I'm not my baby sister who tries to touch fruit bats. And no, she doesn't have a bowler, okay? But there's been lots of talk about it. I just wanted to talk about it and give an understanding to you guys the way I would give an understanding to someone else. And yes, I know it's like a shit understanding, but I don't care. Like, I seriously do not care that it's a shit understanding. It's my understanding, and this is my understanding, bitch. But I actually tried my best to understand it for you guys. I wanted to say, like someone would say it to me, not using all those scientific terms. And I said, the Ebola disease came in 1924 when James George Washington flew a fruit bat into a plane. Yes, I don't want to do stuff like that. I just want to do it nice and simple for you guys to understand. And all that, but I'm just going to do a quick breakdown of what I've said. So Ebola is a disease that is carried out through humans and some animals, like the fruit bat and the gorilla, and I can't remember which one, and bat droppings. And it is going quickly around, it is like quickly becoming a popular thing throughout social networks, and all that. There's four main ways. It's blood, mucus, semen, and something else, but again they'll be on the screen so you'll see that. And just stay safe, everyone. There's not really that much to say. So, just, if you guys did enjoy the video, leave a like on it. Of course, I know I don't do much of these videos and all that, but you get what I mean. I'm trying to give a message to people and all that, and just stop making a big deal out of it. If you live in America, or I know most people live in America, I wouldn't be making a big deal of it, but I also would. Like, I want to go screaming out, I've got Ebola! Someone kill me before that my eyes start bleeding! Like, no, just stay calm and relax. And if you're scared, you're scared. It's okay. I was just say, thanks for listening to my little speech, blah blah blah, whatever you want to call it these days. And if you liked it, leave a like, and I'll see you next time, and I'll just really keep this up. And bye bye. Thank you.